many people believe that this is just a myth. But I don't think so. And there was another man who doesn't believe so. His name is King Saddam Hussein of past Iraq. He's been spending, over the last 20 years, over $1 billion. That's what he did. He was planning to rebuild Babylon, and he was also planning to rebuild the Tower of Babel. Now, is this guy a Christian? I don't think so. Does he believe the Bible to be true? I don't think so. So why is he spending all this money and time to rebuild a myth? Well, he doesn't believe it's a myth. Why didn't he believe it's a myth? Well, because there are clay tablets. These are not inspired, written by past kings of Babylon, telling future kings of Babylon to rebuild Babylon. And Iraq is nothing more than modern-day Babylon. So he was using this information and building the Tower of Babel and that of Babylon. But if we all go back to one ancient civilization, and when people spread throughout the world to build other ancient civilizations, there should be a connection. There should be similarities in building construction, similarities in pagan religions, also that of mathematics. And there should be a similar accounts of creation and the flood. Why? Because everybody goes back to Noah as their great-great-great-grandfather. They knew these accounts. When they spread throughout the world, they would bring these accounts. And we're going to start with Ur of the Chaldeans. This was Abraham's hometown. It actually existed. There's a ziggurat, and this is what they believe that ziggurat looked like. On the top of this pyramid, there was a temple. Nimrod was worshiping the hosts of heaven. That's the sun, moon, and stars. And these hosts, deities. Travel to Egypt. This is one of the oldest pyramids there. This is a step pyramid. Again, the construction is very similar to those in the Mesopotamia area. Traveling to Mexico City. This is Teotihuacan. This pyramid is dedicated to the sun god. They have another one dedicated to the moon god. Again, worshiping the hosts of heaven, similar to Nimrod at the Tower of Babel. Travel a little further south to the Mayan culture. Again, they have pyramids and temples on top. Travel to Cambodia, ancient civilizations. Again, have pyramids and temples. Himalayas, same thing. China also has that of a pyramid. Even in Europe, they find these pyramids. Now, some of these pyramids are made out of stone. Sometimes they're made out of stone and dirt, and sometimes they're only made out of dirt. But again, the construction is very similar. Even when you travel to the United States, guess what they find in ancient Indian cultures? Pyramids. Yeah, this one here is about 100 feet high. The base took up 16 square acres. That's a lot of dirt piled into a pyramid. And they believe there were temples on top of these pyramids. And these ancient civilizations also had another fascination, something in common. They had a fascination with the stars. Stonehenge here was built, again, focusing on the motion of the heavenly host. Traveling back to the United States, this here was by that pyramid. This is a wood hinge by the ancient Indians. Now, it's made out of wood instead of stone, but the function, again, is very similar to what's found in Europe. Even in the ancient Egyptian culture, the ancient Egyptians, when they built their pyramids, they would build their pyramids focusing on the motions of the heavenly host. In this photograph right here, the sun will set right behind one of the pyramids during the winter solstice. Again, there seems to be a connection with these ancient civilizations.